In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Shamoshum, why does the church prohibit polygamy?
So just like how God made Adam and Eve, he didn't make more wives. He just made Adam and Eve. So he made the two one. And if you see, even after them, there was only just one wife. And then eventually, someone's human idea, he began to marry multiple wives, but God never commanded to marry multiple wives. And in the apostolic era and the apostolic tradition, it was reaffirmed that we should only marry one wife, as St. Paul says. There are incidents in the early church where you will see converts who were already married before they became Christian, mm-hmm, to multiple wives. Their marriage was recognized, but the next generation, like their sons, were only allowed to marry one wife. So right, it was only accepted in the case of converts.
Okay, then is it permissible for a Christian believer to unite with a non-Christian in this holy matrimony?
Of course not, because in order to participate in the holy sacraments, one needs to already be in the door, meaning one needs to have already been baptized and chrismated. Right. So the necessity of being a Christian is already there. You have to be a Christian to participate in Christian sacraments. So, and in marriage, before the marriage, correct me if I'm wrong, Abuna, the married couple has to do confession with the priest.
We prefer it, right.
Right, so how can they do confession with the priest if they're not even baptized or chrismated yet? Unless in the case of conversion again. So there was an example here in our parish of a Muslim couple, man and wife, they converted. So they received the sacraments of confession, baptism, chrismation, and marriage all at the same time, and obviously communion. So in this case then, Christianity is a pre-qualification of participating in marriage, or else it's not a sacrament, because God is not going to make two one if they are not two in Him already.
100%. What about like the person cohabitate with another or take a partner outside the sacrament of marriage?
So they would be living in sin in the eyes of the church. And there are, I know as a layperson myself, I know of three cases where this situation was real in different archdioceses, and in each case, the local parish priest told those who participated in this that they would no longer be allowed to receive communion until they do confession and get married. And he would say, come, let me marry you. Why are you waiting? So you wouldn't be living in sin anymore.
Shamosho, for this issue, we have situations why this is happening. As some of those people, they go with this. Okay, then Abuna, is it important to stay virgin before getting marriage? Could we have a kiss before getting married? Could we do this and that? Those questions come from the lack of spirituality.
One time in the Zoom Bible studies that the American Archdiocese were doing, I think it was Sayyidina, he said, why are you asking the same questions every day? Sometimes the questions come like maybe, they'll get the answer they want. Or something. It's then it tells you, the person who's asking, it tells you in your heart what you know is right and what you know is wrong. And then if it tells you that, and it tells you that you like the wrong, this is a sign that there's something wrong in your spirituality and a call from God to you to repent.
To repent and grow in knowledge. If you want to be holy, then you will get blessing. Then why you're asking for this sacrament if you always look about the lust, physical ways only? Then sex is not enough. Even psychologically says, love doesn't continue after marriage. It changed, the body changed. Doesn't mean that love will vanish. No, love will transfer in responsibility. When you love another woman or the woman love another guy, then they will look just, they will live like in movies. In movies, like life ended in 2 hours. Even love itself ended in 2 hours. But after the movie, what happens? This is marriage. The ending of the movie is going to the church and starting the blessing of the marriage. For that, prepare yourself, repent. Don't think about, especially women, if you give the man the physical issues and doing sex with them, they will not take you as a wife anymore. And you don't want to ruin your life, your marriage. Wait, be humble, trust the Lord, ask the Lord to help you. Don't think that marriage will cure your lust, because you will have it later, then you will have another struggle. Cure yourself by the grace of the Lord, to be prepared to be holy and one with your husband or with your wife. For that, it's important to go repent, ask, don't be shy. I know here, this is not an issue of to be shy, but some of the Eastern youth, they're coming from the East to the West. Don't be shy. This is your life. You need to ask. Come and talk with the priest. Even if you're shy, tell the priest, it's something I don't want you to judge me. And the priest will tell you, I will not judge you, because in this situation, you will grow in my eyes. And may the Lord sanctify you all, sanctify all the marriages, and let it all be for the glory of the Lord. Thank you, Shamosh.